Okay, so double three eight bolt is coming together. I wanted to fit this. I don't know why this thing is struggling to focus, but it's not necessary. That one over there will do. It's a little bit higher, but the power supply is now completed. I've got 1047K resistors in there. So 470 kilo ohms in total, ordinary full wave bridge, 1N4007s I think it is, close to 5 kV cap. The tube, so now the base is fitted, but the tube is in the wrong way. That's just to show the name for now, the 833A, and it's brand new. And of course I'll have to make a plan with these. Isolated at the top here, but this tube actually sits the other way around. Let me just try and get it to go in here. Okay, so we'll have to make a plan with that. Capacitor. I made an adapter here, so that will stick through the front. Front plate, it's gonna come on here. We got all the plates together now. All brand spanking new, so that'll be fitted. And of course I've got to make up my mind between the HT chokes. I want top end, and this one is not going to have enough inductance. It's about 94 micro Henry, and believe it or not, this one is 400 micro Henry, and that's because I have a piece of ferrite that I put in it long time ago. I bought a 472 kilohertz transmitter, and this was the HT choke for it. So maybe I'll remove that or just make up something else. So I'm going to take the HT from there and from this cap, and use an isolator at the top, and then of course this will be mounted some way, supplying the tube with HT on this end here. And is that correct? Yes, that's correct. That's the right one. This one here. That's the grid. If you follow it inside, you'll see it goes to the grids. So, and then of course, in from the tube to the capacitor, and from the capacitor to the inductor network. And I'm gonna go through somewhere here with a through mount, something like that, maybe a bigger one, I'm not sure yet, to get to the bottom where the loading cap is, the antenna relay. It's also in the bottom, and this doesn't need a lot of air, but I made this a long time ago. It's just an ordinary LM317 adjustable voltage regulator for the fans. And if I need to get something bigger, then I'll use a 220 volt or whatever, but I doubt it's going to be necessary. So that is so far we got. We got a fuse, but this is going to be replaced with a 10 amp switch. So it'll trip by itself. This will be the on-off switch. Yeah, I've got some other plan with this. This hole was in there, so I'm gonna make a plan. Maybe I'll try and fit a orange piece of perglass, perspex, whatever in here, and fit the light behind it so it'll shine through. And I've got to try and cover the holes that I don't need, so just so it doesn't look as bad. But it was a pan that was already made, so. Alright, so on the rear. Nothing fancy yet. Oil spike. And your in and your out. And the antenna relay for a foot switch or automatic triggering from the rig. And there the 220 volt in. So it's been a few days and it looks like nothing has happened. We've got the 10 volt 10 amp filament transformer. It was mounted below, it's sticking halfway through to save some space in the bottom, because this transformer is rather hefty. It's big in size, and would have given me millimeters, maybe a half a millimeter to a millimeter of clearance, and that might vibrate against the bottom plate or the bottom of the pan. So, but we're getting there, slowly but surely. All right, this is part two of the old A33A linear wheel. See when we can do another one when something a little bit more has been happening over here. Later, guys.